Today's topic is integrated rate law for zero order reaction. In this chapter, chemical kinetics, n number of times we'll be talking about rate of a reaction and rate constant. You must understand this. That is, rate of a reaction and rate constant are different. Now, let us consider a reaction where A moles of A reacts with B moles of B to give some product. Now, you know how to write the rate expression for a given reaction. There are three ways in which you can write the rate expression for a given reaction. First one is by using the definition of the rate of a reaction. By the definition, we can write the rate of this reaction as rate is equal to, with respect to A, when you write, we write it as minus 1 by A d A by dt. This is equal to minus 1 by B d B by dt. And with respect to product, when we write it as plus d p by dt. And this is not the new thing that we are studying, right? We have discussed about this. Second method is by using law of mass action. So by using law of mass action, the rate of this reaction can be written as rate is equal to k into molar concentration of A raised to the power of A into molar concentration of B raised to the power of B. And this expression is called as theoretical rate expression. In theoretical rate expression, or when you apply law of mass action, we write the molar concentration terms raised to their stoichiometric coefficients. Third way is by using rate law. We can also write the rate expression. So by using rate law, we can write the rate expression as rate is equal to k into molar concentration of A raised to the power of m and molar concentration of B raised to the power of n. Here m and n has no relation with the stoichiometric coefficients A and B. M and n may or may not be equal to A and B. And we call this expression as experimentally determined rate expression. Out of these three expressions, we have nothing to do with this second expression. So nowhere we will use theoretical rate expression. So we'll just eliminate this. Okay. Now, in the third expression, we have this constant K. And we call this K as the rate constant. So now, when a reaction is given, you can write the rate expression either by using the definition of the rate of a reaction or by using rate law. When you use definition, you write the rate expression like this. By using rate law, this is how you will write the rate expression. Now, let us take this expression. In this expression, there are infinitesimally small quantities like dA, dt, dB, dp. So this dA, dt, dp, they're all infinitesimally very small quantities, which cannot be practically measured. So what we will do is, we will just integrate this expression. This expression is called as the differential rate expression. So we just integrate this differential rate expressions to get quantities which can be measured so that the rate of the reaction and rate constant can be determined. So when we integrate the differential rate expression, we get integrated rate law. So now first we will take a zero order reaction and we will see what is the integrated rate law for a zero order reaction, or to derive an expression for the rate constant of a zero order reaction. Let us see how to derive an expression for the rate constant of a zero order reaction. We all know what is a zero order reaction. A reaction in which the rate is independent of the molar concentration of the reactant, or the rate is directly proportional to the zeroth power of the molar concentration of the reactant. Let us consider a zero order reaction where R gives product. This is a zero order reaction. So we have considered this as a zero order reaction. Since this is a zero order reaction, you know the rate is proportional to the zeroth power of the molar concentration of the reactant. Now, we will write the rate expression for this reaction by using rate law and by using the definition. Using rate law, we can write the rate of this reaction as rate is equal to K into molar concentration of R raised to the power of 0, because this is a zero order reaction. Anything raised to the power of 0 is 1. So we can write rate is equal to K. And let us call this equation as equation number 1. Now, by using definition, the rate of this reaction can be written as rate is equal to minus dR by dt. And let us call this equation as equation number 2. Now, from equation 1 and 2, we can write minus dR by dt is equal to K. You know, if A is equal to B and A is equal to C, then B is equal to C. So rate is equal to K, rate is equal to minus dr by dt. So we can write minus dr by dt equal to K. Now, by rearranging the terms, we can write the same expression as dr is equal to minus K into dt. Now, let us integrate this expression. So integrating this expression, and this is the integration symbol, you will get to know about integration. So when you study integration chapter in mathematics, okay? So integration of dr is equal to integration of minus k dt. Now, you must integrate this. So what you must do here is, just you must remember this one step, or just by this step for time being. Once you study integration in mathematics, you will come to know that the integration of this term is very simple. Okay. The integration of this function is r. This is equal to minus k is a constant, and integration of dt is t. And whenever you integrate, you must always add an integration constant. Here c is called as the integration constant, or sometimes even we write I, capital letter I. Okay. Now C is the integration constant. After integrating, an integration constant will appear. Now we have to find the value of C. So to find C, let us call this equation as equation number 3. Now, to find C, what we will do is, when t is equal to 0, in the time t is equal to 0, r, the molar concentration of r will become equal to r0. Here, r is the molar concentration of the reactant after a certain time interval. This term indicates the molar concentration of the reactant after a certain time interval. R0 is the molar concentration of the reactant, the initial molar concentration of the reactant, or the molar concentration of the reactant at time t equal to 0. What does it mean? See, we have considered this reaction. Suppose initially there were 100 moles of R. That is, at time t equal to 0, there were 100 moles of R. Now, once the reaction starts, let us say after a certain time t, out of 100 moles, 60 moles of R has decomposed to give P. 60 moles of R is decomposed to give P. P. So how many moles of P is formed? 60 moles of P is formed. Now, after a certain time T, what is the concentration of R left? Or what is the number of moles of R left? Out of 100, if 60 decompose, left is 40. So here, this term indicates the molar concentration of the reactant after a certain time T. Okay, R0 is the initial concentration. So here, what is the initial concentration? That is 100. Now, at time T equal to 0, when there is no conversion of R to P, this R will be same as R0. Okay, so to find C, we take when time T equal to 0, R will be equal to R0. Now, substitute this in equation 3. So what we get? R is R0. This is equal to minus K into T is 0. So we write minus K into 0 plus C. So what we get? We get R0 is equal to K into 0, 0 plus C. So we get C. So what is the value of C? C is R0. Now substitute the value of C in equation number 3. If you substitute the value of C in equation 3, what we get? We get R is equal to minus KT plus C is R0. Now, if you take minus KT to the left hand side, it will become plus KT. This is equal to R0. When this plus R crosses the equal sign, we get minus R. So what will be K? K is equal to R0 minus R divided by T. So this is the expression for the rate constant of a zero order reaction. And for board exam and even for competitive exams, this is very important. K is the rate constant. R0 is the initial concentration of the reactant. This is the concentration of the reactant after a certain time T, and this is the time. Now, what does this term, numerator term, indicates? The numerator term is the change in concentration. Change in concentration with time. So what is change in concentration with time is defined as rate of a reaction. So from this expression, it is evident that for a zero order reaction, the rate constant is equal to the rate of a reaction at all concentration. Rate constant is equal to rate of a reaction at all concentration. Okay, is this clear to you? Once again, I will repeat this. We must consider a zero order reaction. So by rate law, we write the rate expression as like this. Next, by definition, the rate is written as minus dr by dt. So from equation 1 and 2, we get this. Rearranging the term, we get this expression. Now you have to integrate this expression. So integration of this, we get it as R is equal to minus kt plus C, where C is the integration constant. Now to find C, what we do is we take when time t equal to 0, this R will be equal to initial concentration. So substitute this in equation 3. So we get the value of C. So once you get the value of C, substitute C in equation 3 and simplify, you get the expression for K. Okay. After this, the most important part of this derivation for the competitive examination is the graphs. Let us take this expression. In this expression, if you look at this expression is of the form y is equal to mx plus c. You know what does this equation y is equal to mx plus c represent? It is the general equation of a straight line. For a straight line, the general equation is y is equal to mx plus c. So where m is called as the slope and c is called as the y-intercept. Here, if we plot a graph for y is equal to mx plus c, you will get a straight line like this. Whenever there is some certain value of c, then this straight line will touch the y-axis at some point. If the c is not there, if c is zero, then the straight line starts from the origin. That indicates the y-intercept is zero. What is y-intercept? The point where the line touches the y-axis. This is y-intercept. That is c. If the c is zero, then the line will start from the origin. And if m is positive, if the slope is positive, then the line will go upward. If m is negative, then it will have a negative slope like this. So these are the some of the things you must know, because now we are going to plot many graphs for zero order reaction. First, let us take this. Look at this expression. This expression is of the form y is equal to mx plus c. Here you see the slope. The slope is minus k. That is, the slope is negative. So if you plot a graph of y versus x, that is concentration of r versus t. Concentration of r versus time. The concentration versus time. The slope is negative and there is a y-intercept. Therefore, the graph will go like this. And what is this? This is the y-intercept. And what is its value? This is r naught. And what is the slope? Slope is minus k. Slope is minus k. So it is very, very, very important for competitive exams. They give a graph and options are given. The slope of this graph is, for a zero order reaction, the slope of this graph is. What is the slope of the graph? That is minus k. This is one of the graph. And let us take this expression. So this expression, we can rewrite it as kt is equal to r naught minus r. What is r naught minus r? R naught minus r is the change in the concentration. So we'll let us represent it as x. Now, kt is equal to x. We can assume that it is also of the form y is equal to mx. Here, this is x and this is t. Now, what is x? X is the change in concentration. So, if we plot a graph of change in concentration versus time, what is change in concentration? That is r naught minus r. If you plot the change in concentration versus time, you see there is no y-intercept. C is zero. So the straight line starts from origin. And you see the value of slope. Slope is positive. So you get a straight line like this. And what is the slope? Slope is k, which is equal to the rate constant. And what is the y-intercept? Y-intercept is zero. There is one more graph which is very important in case of a zero order reaction. That is the concentration or the rate of a reaction versus concentration. For a zero order reaction, you know that rate is independent of molar concentration of the reactant. You go on changing the concentration of the reactant, the rate will not change. Therefore, you will get a straight line which is parallel to x-axis. A straight line parallel to x-axis. In this case, the slope is zero. Here the slope is zero. Even if you take the differential rate versus time, even in that case also, you will get a straight line parallel to x-axis and the slope is zero. So these are the three very, very important graphs that is related to zero order reaction. So you must study this. And you know the unit of rate constant for a zero order reaction. In the last class we have seen What is the unit of the rate constant of a zero order reaction? It is same as the rate of the reaction, that is mole per liter per second. Okay, so these are very important things. You must study this. This is all for today's class. In the next class, we will derive an integrated rate law for first order reaction, and we will discuss the various graphs related to first order reaction. Okay.